The ADSR module is used to modulate a signal, such as our synth volume, and to help emulate the way real-world instruments can sound and respond. In this video, we'll take a look at how the ADSR module works, and we'll use it as a volume gate for the notes we play. In the last video, we added an ADSR module to our synth, which solved our problems of the notes ringing out indefinitely. Let's take a look at how we can take control of how the ADSR module responds to a note being played. There are four parameters on the ADSR module that we're going to be changing: the attack, the decay, the sustain, and the release. Let's add four sliders, one for each parameter. Under Controls, click Slider, and click inside the container to place it. I'll copy and paste it three times. Now, connect each slider to the four pins on the ADSR module: attack, decay, sustain, and release. I'll rename the sliders so we know what they're connected to. Attack, decay, sustain, and release. I'll set decay and release to 0, but leave sustain set at 7. The ADSR module splits the note into four stages: attack, decay, sustain, and release. Here, I have an image explaining how an ADSR gate works. You can see that the ADSR affects a signal's amplitude over time. The first stage is attack. The attack stage determines the length of time it takes for the signal to reach full volume after a key has been pressed. With the attack set to 0, the note will reach full volume immediately after I press a key. If I set the attack to 8, when I press a key, the note fades in over time until it reaches its maximum volume. Once the note reaches its maximum volume, the attack stage is complete, and the decay stage begins. Decay is the amount of time it takes the signal to drop from its maximum level to its sustain level. Basically, the note fades in during the attack stage and fades down, but not all the way out, in the decay stage. I'll set decay to 8 and sustain to 1. Now, when I press a key, the note fades in until it reaches its maximum volume, and then fades out over time until it reaches its sustain level. At this point, the third stage begins, the sustain stage. The sustain stage is a little different from the other three stages. Each of the other stages' value represents time, the time it takes for that particular stage to complete. Sustain, however, represents amplitude. The sustain value represents how loud the signal is during the sustain stage. The length of the sustain stage is determined by how long you hold the key down. I'll set sustain to 7, and attack and decay to 0. If I press a key, since attack and decay are set to 0, the note immediately enters the sustain stage, ringing out at the sustain level until I release the key. When I release the key, the note enters its fourth stage, the release stage. The release stage is the amount of time it takes for the note to fade from its sustain level to silence. This is how long the note rings out after the key has been released. Since it's currently set to 0, when I release a key, the note is immediately silent. If I turn release up to 8 and press a key, when I release that key, the note enters the release stage. It begins to fade out until it reaches silence. So the ADSR module gives us four stages: attack, decay, sustain, and release. When we press a key, the note enters its attack stage and fades in until it reaches its maximum volume. It then enters the second stage, the decay stage, where it begins to fade out until it reaches its sustain level. When the note enters the sustain stage, it holds at that level until the key is released. The note then enters the release stage and fades out to silence. If you want to control the level that the signal reaches during its attack stage, you can add a slider to control the overall level on the ADSR module. Click on Slider and place it in the container. Connect the slider to the overall level plug on the ADSR module. Rename the slider to Level. Now you can set the maximum volume that the note will reach. Even though I'm using this ADSR envelope to automate the volume, it can be used to affect other signals too. It can control the pitch of a note or the cutoff of a filter. Any voltage can be controlled using this envelope, so mess around with it and see what you can come up with. Thanks for watching. If you found this content helpful, please consider supporting me on Patreon. Comment, like, and share this video, and subscribe for more tutorials. See you next time.